The word dream originated from a German root meaning joy and music. And dreams can be joyful. They can also be terrifying. But they're just illusions. Yet, while we're in them, they're so real. In a way, we go to a different land at night. Dreamland. I want to know why we do this, why we dream. Or rather, how we can use scientific studies to propose a few theories. My name is Kathleen Thornsberry, and welcome to Dreamland. By the end of this piece, hopefully you will be able to decipher meaning behind your dreams. But to do this, let's start at the beginning. The medical dictionary defines dreams as a mental phenomenon occurring during REM sleep in which images, emotions, and thoughts are experienced with a sense of reality. Wait, what's REM?
I'm Elizabeth Parsons, and I am a pulmonary and sleep doctor at Harborview at the University of Washington. So I did my medical school training at Duke, graduated from there in 2004. Then I did medical residency training in medicine, internal medicine and pediatrics at Harvard. And then I came out here to the University of Washington, and I did training in pulmonary and critical care medicine. I did clinical training in that and then did some years of research. And now I am completing a 1-year subspecialty fellowship in sports medicine.
Meet Dr. Elizabeth Parsons. I interviewed her, and she was extremely helpful in helping me explore deeper into my topic. You'll hear her throughout this piece, and hopefully she'll be really helpful to you too.
Sure. So one of the exciting things about sleep medicine is that there's a lot of it we don't really understand. So why people have the different sleep cycles is still a little bit unclear. I can tell you kind of what the basics are for a normal adult, being that the brain becomes more, people have started studying sleep even as in babies and in infants, and they've found that sleep is kind of very, kind of primitive in babies. As you mentioned, there are these four sleep stages that we tend to see. So what happens is it's this cyclical process where a patient starts out in what we call kind of the lighter stages of sleep, and those are the lower numbers. So people start out in what's called N1 or non-REM 1, which is a light stage of sleep, generally transition down into a second stage of non-REM called N2, which is a little bit deeper, then into what's called N3. Some people used to call that slow wave sleep. And then the next transition would be into REM sleep, or rapid eye movement.
Quick side note. REM stands for rapid eye movement. So if you looked at someone while they were in REM, their eyes under their eyelids would be moving back and forth really, really fast.
And that's what we typically think of as kind of being dream sleep. But it's interesting, dreams don't just happen in that stage, but it's kind of the original stage that was recognized as being associated with dreams. And then what typically happens is someone will hang out in that stage, the normal individual, they'll hang out in REM sleep for a certain period of time, maybe 30 minutes. And then the normal cycle is to kind of go back up again into one of the lighter stages and then start that step-down process again. Through that process of those step-downs, maybe 3 or 4 times in the night, and we really don't understand why it is that people go through these different stages.
We know what's happening with our brain activity during REM, but what about our bodies? It turns out, to keep us from actually acting out our dreams, our brain releases a message that stops us from moving. 3 parts are involved to make our muscles do this: the pons and medulla, both in the brain, and the spine. The pons helps relay messages between the parts of the brain and the spinal cord in everyday life. The medulla controls automatic functions like breathing and also relaying messages. The muscle relaxation process starts when the, get ready for it, paralocus ceruleus nucleus of the pons excite neurons of a part of the medulla The medulla then gives signals to the spinal alpha motor neurons, which control muscle contraction, to stop. From the spine, all the muscles get the message, and this causes muscle atonia, that paralyzation. If that just flew over your head, here's another explanation.
So REM sleep, the way I kind of think of it is, you know, a typical normal REM sleep is that you would be able to dream, and you might dream that you're flying or jumping off the Empire State Building, but for safety reasons, your body is not letting you move.
Right.
You really shouldn't move while you're in your dreams, or it could be dangerous. Now, remember our original question? Why do we dream? This REM sleep atonia, or lack thereof, might help us figure this out. For everything that goes right in our bodies, there is also something that can go wrong. Or we can make it go wrong. REM sleep is no exception. There was a researcher named Michel Jouvet who performed a cat experiment in the 1960s in France. He made lesions in the pons of 35 cats so the muscle paralyzation during REM would no longer happen. Then, researchers studied the cats as they slept. Normally, for a cat, its stages 1 through 2 are lighter, so the cat might be sitting up. For its stages 3 through REM, it's probably curled in a ball, twitching and even making noises sometimes. These stages are when the deep muscle relaxation sets in. And for REM sleep, cats are normally twitching, but they cannot be woken up easily. Imagine you are one of Jouvet's researchers, sitting in front of a cage with a clipboard, watching this post-surgical cat sleep, and after a while of being in a deep sleep, it gets up. The cat's eyes are still closed, but it starts walking towards you, and then walks faster, until the cat is running toward you at full speed and rams into the cage. You jump back a bit. Is the cat awake? It couldn't be. Its eyes are closed. Then it loops around for a bit. It goes to one corner. It goes to another corner. It pounces on something, then runs after something. The cat is doing its favorite activity. Hunting. Now, not only is this a daytime thing for the cat, but it's a nighttime one, too. Cats hunt in their REM sleep. That's what they dream about.